In this video, I am going to explain movement of spines. Particularly, I want to focus on that lumbar spines actually don't rotate. So when you rotate your core, when you rotate your abdomen, where is this rotation happening? Many people might think that's happening in lumbar spines. But as I said, lumbar spines actually do not rotate. I will explain why and where is rotation happening. So let's go to anatomy of lumbar spine first. You are looking lumbar spines and sacrum, and its view is slightly from lateral view, from back and lateral. You are looking lumbar spines kind of a 3, 4, and 5. The key structure for today is here, this part. This is joint between each spine. This joint is called facet joint. Facet joint. There are facet joints in cervical spines, thoracic spines, and of course in lumbar spines. I want you to focus on how they face each other. Again, let's focus on facet joint. This is superior part of facet joint. This is inferior part of facet joint. The angle of facet joint is fairly vertical, right? This is pretty much vertical. It's close to the vertical. Then when you try to rotate your core, then lumbar spine hits to this facet joint. I will say that again. Facet joint is close to vertical. It's pretty much vertical. When you try to rotate your core, this part of facet joint kind of crash into the other facet joint, because orientation of joint is pretty much vertical because of this structure, because of architecture of facet joint. Lumbar spines do not rotate that much. There are 5 lumbar spines, L1 through L5. The total range of motion of rotation is only 10 degrees. Through whole lumbar spines, they all can do 10 degrees rotation. 10 degrees for a total rotation. So it's like 5 degrees for right rotation and 5 degrees for left rotation. This 10 degree is total rotational movement throughout whole lumbar spines. That's a very little amount of rotation, right? This only 10 degrees is because their facet joint is pretty much vertical. That is why this bony structure kind of blocks rotational movement. Okay, so lumbar spines cannot rotate that much because of the structure of lumbar spines. But when you do rotational movement, when you do a golf, when you play tennis, kind of a rotational movement activity, where is rotational movement happening? That must be the other place, right? Let's go to thoracic spines. This is thoracic spines. I want you to focus on facet joint. Let's focus this part. Facet joint of thoracic spine is not that vertical compared to lumbar spines. Let's go back to lumbar again. This is lumbar spine facet joint. It's pretty much vertical. Thoracic spines. It's still close to vertical, but it's not that vertical compared to lumbar spines. Let's see. Here, this is not that vertical. So there is possibility for rotation because the angle of facet joint is close to horizon. not completely horizon, but it's better than vertical. Because of this structure, thoracic spines can rotate more than lumbar spines. Range of motion of rotation for thoracic spines is about 70 degrees. 70 degrees total. So, 35 degrees for right rotation, 35 degrees for left rotation. How much is rotational movement for lumbar spines? It was only 10 degrees for total direction, right? It's 10 degrees total. It's 70 versus 10 degrees. That's a big difference, correct? So when you do golf, when you do tennis, when you do baseball, and you do a rotational training for core, actually you need to focus on movement of thoracic spines. Look at the number. 70 degrees for thoracic spines and 10 degrees for lumbar spines. Lumbar spine is not actually good for rotation. They are good for flexion, extension, and side bend. Let's go back to lumbar again. They are good for flexion, extension. Flexion, extension, and side bend. Because of structure of facet joint. So rotation is not their favorite. Thoracic spines, yep, their favorite is rotation and flexion because of the structure of facet joint. Actually, cervical spine is the most flexible spines for rotational movement. But in terms of core rotation, thoracic spine is key structure. But just in case, let's look at cervical spine. See, I want you to focus on facet joint. This is C3, this is C4. Look at how horizon the facet joint is. This part is facet joint of cervical spine. It's pretty much horizon, right? It's close to horizon. That is why cervical spine can do a lot of rotation. By the way, the most of rotation in cervical spine is happening between C1 and C2. This is very flexible part. Anyway, let's compare the angle of facet joint between cervical spines and lumbar spines again. See, this is close to vertical. This is close to horizon. So bony structure can inhibit movement of rotation. See, lumbar spine literally blocks movement of rotational movement. As I said, when you do core rotation, thoracic spine is key for the movement. However, I want to add one more place that is important for core rotation, which is here, hip movement. You know, core movement is not isolated. It's not independent. Each joint is involved for core movement, such as golf swing, baseball swing, tennis movement. Every part of body is involved for each movement. So your hip flexibility is key for core rotation movement. Why? Because when your hip does not move, somebody has to compensate for rotational movement. Guess who? Maybe thoracic spines. Maybe lumbar spines. Or maybe cervical spine needs to compensate if hip doesn't move. Makes sense. Then if hip doesn't move, even lumbar spine may need to compensate, even though their range of motion is only 10 degrees. Thus, flexible hip movement is very important for athletic movement, plus injury prevention. As I said, if your hip doesn't move, maybe lumbar spines or thoracic spines need to compensate instead of hip movement. If this is very tight, maybe lumbar spine has chance to get injury. See, hip movement is crucial for core movement. By the way, that is why I focus on hip flexibility in my treatment videos. So in this video, I explained why lumbar spine is not good for rotational movement. Bony structure literally blocks rotational movement. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.